In this video, you'll see how to build generative AI applications using Amazon OpenSearch Service Machine Learning connectors. With ML connectors, you can integrate with third-party services, leverage existing open-source ML algorithms to develop new ML features, and build semantic search to power your applications. OpenSearch is a flexible, scalable, open-source engine built on Apache Lucene that can be used as a vector database. A typical ingestion pattern will look like this, where your enterprise's raw data is converted to vector embeddings using ML models. Vector embeddings are numerical representations of text, image, audio, and video data. The metadata, along with its vectors, is then ingested and stored in OpenSearch. Key challenges today include generating and hydrating vectors, keeping vectors up to date with data changes, and building and maintaining middleware applications to integrate external text embedding models into search and ingestion pipelines. With the latest release of OpenSearch, this undifferentiated heavy lifting has been removed and replaced with a more seamless vector hydration process. Starting with version 2.9, Managed OpenSearch Service introduced an ML framework that includes an ML connector, making it simpler to integrate with external ML models, specifically those hosted on Amazon SageMaker, Amazon Bedrock, Cohere, and OpenAI. The framework also includes an ML Commons plugin. ML Commons for OpenSearch simplifies the development of machine learning features by providing a set of common ML algorithms through transport and REST API calls. These integrations are part of the model serving framework that aims to make it easier to operationalize OpenSearch integrations with external models. The framework includes ML extensibility through the ML connector and its blueprint. Amazon ML Access Control leverages the OpenSearch Security plugin and ML Commons to manage access to models that are deployed externally. In this demo, we'll leverage two endpoints that have been deployed on different external services. SageMaker will host a text embedding model, and OpenAI will host a large language model. First, we'll create a connector. Then, we'll leverage the model access to securely access the external endpoints. We'll register the connector on Amazon OpenSearch Service, which will return a model ID. Next, we'll use the model ID to deploy the model. We'll use the model to create a neural pipeline, and then we'll create a vector index. Next, we'll ingest documents into OpenSearch Service, and the service will leverage the ML connector through the index pipeline to generate the required vectors for specific fields. Finally, we'll look at how to perform a vector search and how the vector embedding for the required query term is generated. Now let's get started. This is the IAM console, where two roles have been created for the purposes of this demo, the OpenAI role and the SageMaker role. To get started, let's look at the SageMaker role. This role has full access to the SageMaker service. Alternatively, we could have provided invoke access to a specific model or a model group. This trust policy ensures the tool has access to create the connector in OpenSearch service. Now let's see how we've mapped the role in OpenSearch dashboards. We'll navigate to the security plugin and look at the ML full access role. Here we can see that the ML full access role has been mapped to the SageMaker role that we just saw. Now let's switch to the Postman API client, where we've created an application to deploy a connector. To create a connector, send a POST request to the OpenSearch service domain endpoint. You can use curl, Python, or the tool Postman. Let's review the application's configuration to create the ML connector. On the Authorization tab, we've set the authorization type to AWS Signature. We've provided the IAM Access Key ID and IAM Secret Access Key to create the ML connector. Here, we can see the advanced configuration settings. We've provided the region where the OpenSearch service domain is deployed and a valid session token. The service name for managed OpenSearch service is S. The body tab contains a JSON blueprint. This blueprint contains several important key value pairs, including the service name and region where the remote model exists. This is the ARN for the SageMaker role that has either full or invoke access to the SageMaker service. This is the URL to the external endpoint for our model deployed on SageMaker. The blueprint also includes the request body, which will be passed to our model as an input. You can write your own pre- and post-process functions to parse the neural search request and response for your model format. Let's send a request to our ML plugin to create a connector. We'll copy the connector ID to use in a moment. Now let's switch to the DevTools console in OpenSearch dashboards to register the connector. We'll paste the connector ID that we just copied. Next, let's check for existing model groups. We've already saved the ID for one of the existing model groups, which we'll use in the next step. Next, we'll register the connector within the model group. We've already specified the model group ID, so we just need to update the description and connector ID. Note the SageMaker embedding model we're using. A task ID has been created. We'll copy the task ID and use it to check the registration status. The registration has been completed. Next, we'll copy the model ID and use it to deploy our model. Another task ID has been generated. Let's use it to check the deployment status. The model deployment has been completed, and we can now test the deployed model using the Predict API. Text embeddings were generated by the model ID, indicating the model is working as expected. Next, let's quickly retrieve information about the model. Let's also review the connector information. Here, we can see the endpoint the connector points to and the input the connector takes for generating the embedding. Next, we'll convert an existing lexical index called DemoStore into a semantic search index that contains vectors. Let's search the lexical index. The results include information about products from a sample retail dataset, which is available on GitHub. We'll convert the product name and description fields to vectors. To do this, first let's create a neural pipeline using the model ID we created earlier. Here we've specified the fields coming from our data source and the names of the corresponding vector fields. The pipeline has been created. Next, we'll create the semantic search index. Notice that index KNN is set to true. This setting tells the plugin to create native library indices for the vector index. Additionally, the description vector and name vector fields that we saw in the pipeline have been defined here. Notice the dimension for these fields is 384. This is the dimension that our SageMaker model supports. The semantic search index has been created. Finally, we'll re-index the data from the lexical index to the newly created semantic search index. The re-indexing is complete, and 2,465 documents are now available. The description vector and the name vector fields now contain the vectors generated through the neural pipeline. We can also see the other metadata that was added to the index. Now let's perform a quick search using a sample query. Because we are using the neural plugin, we don't have to convert our input into vectors again. Rather, we can just call a neural query and pass the model ID as a parameter to convert the input into vectors. Let's also add a price field. Now we'll run the search. As expected, The price, name, and description are returned for each product within the scope of our query. The most relevant results are shown first. We can also do a hybrid search. Hybrid search enables us to fine-tune our query results by combining vector search and full-text search in the same query. This is the same query we ran before, but this time it will only return products with prices above $200. Now let's see how we can use the same flow to integrate OpenSearch with a large language model hosted on OpenAI. Let's quickly review the application configuration in the Postman API client. Note the OpenAI model we're using. We've configured access to the specified endpoint using an API key that has been configured in AWS Secrets Manager. We've also provided the credentials for the OpenAI role we saw earlier. Here, we've specified the public endpoint for our model. The request body includes the parameters required to make predictions. Let's execute this template. A connector ID has been created. Let's copy it and return to the DevTools console. First, we'll paste the connector ID. Next, we'll register the connector with the same model group we used earlier. A task ID is returned. Let's use it to check the registration status. The registration has been completed. Next, we'll copy the ID for our OpenAI large language model and use it to deploy the model. Next, we'll use the task ID to check if the deployment is complete. The model deployment has been completed. Next, we'll test the LLM model using the Predict API and pass the prompts as messages. Let's review the results. The LLM model quickly assumed the persona of an assistant and answered the question, "What's AWS?" With the model working as expected, we could now use a retrieval augmented generation framework to integrate our model with an information retrieval system. In summary, OpenSearch ML connectors can help you create and personalize semantic search applications, build native integrations with active embedding services, implement external ML connectors to power your applications, secure and manage access to ML models, and leverage the distributed design of OpenSearch to build stable, scalable vector databases. With the latest version, you can now create ML connectors to specific model hosts through the Amazon OpenSearch Console user interface on the Integrations page. You've just seen how to build generative AI applications using Amazon OpenSearch Service ML connectors. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.